They have stolen your positivity. They have stolen your sanity. They have stolen your peace. Right? They have stolen your joy. They have stolen your happiness. And we've allowed these people to stay in our life for years. That's like you allowing a robber to come into your house and just allow the robber to take his precious time or her precious time. And just sit back on your couch like this, like, hey, man, stop stealing stuff. Please stop. This is what we sound like, right? When we complain about things we're not willing to change. Please stop stealing. Hey, you please don't steal that. Don't steal that. You shouldn't steal that. And we just sitting back watching. That's why I say it comes to a place and a point in your life where you got to stop complaining. You got to start making changes. You got to start making changes in your life because some of us, we're allowing these thieves, these dream killers, these peace stealers, whatever you want to call these people, we've allowed them to come into our life and we just give it away. We just give it away. We just give it away. Right? Every single day you have people in your life and some of you might not, right? Maybe it's a job. Hell, I don't know what it is. Maybe it's a job. Maybe it's a person. Maybe it's an environment. It's different for all of us. But whatever it is in your life that you're choosing to keep there and you're choosing to allow the thing to rob your peace, to steal your happiness, to steal your happiness, to steal your joy. Right? And you're around these things every single day. When is enough going to be enough? When is enough going to be enough? And I see you see your dad for your grandkids, your dad, I will fight. Okay, I understand that. Right? That's no question. That was a common sense thing I was talking about. But I wanted to just show you how we will fight for things. And I'm not talking about people right now. I'm not talking about our loved ones. But we will fight for things. Some of us will fight harder for a purse that somebody's trying to steal. Some of us will fight harder for a hat that somebody is trying to steal than we do for our own souls, than we do for our own sanity, than we do for our own selves. Right? We got to get to a point where we say, man, if you're trying to come into my life to take anything, I'm not allowing it. I'm not allowing it. I'm not allowing you to come into my life and take anything. Right? I might have opened the door to my life. I might have gave you access because you manipulated me, because you made me think you were somebody that you wasn't, because you sweet talked me, because your presentation was good and I fell for the presentation. But I'm not going to keep allowing you to stay in my life and keep allowing you to take the things that fill me up. Some of us, the reason why we are the way we are and we're at the way we're at, where we're at, the place that we're at, is not because you don't have it in you. It's because you have decided to become a person that other people wanted you to be. You have turned into a person that was beneficial to them. You have turned into a person that was beneficial to that job. You have turned into a person that's beneficial to the world, but it ain't beneficial to you. And you've allowed these things to keep happening in your life. How much more valuable is your life than your possessions? How much more valuable is your emotions than your possessions? How much more valuable are you than those things? If we can go hard for things, can't we go hard for ourselves? If we can say hell no to somebody trying to take something from our life, can't we say hell no to someone trying to take something from our soul? Can we? We can't sit in this place, and some of you I know are going to be like, I don't understand what happiness is anymore. I get it, and let me tell you something, man. I'm not sorry. I don't know why I'm saying I'm sorry. Because I want you to get this and understand this, and I've been saying this for the last 10 years. It's nothing new. If you continue to stay in it, if you continue to allow these, whatever it is, people, things, whatever, places, if you continue to allow it in your life, it will continue to produce whatever it is in your life. I just want you to think about that tonight. Because some of us are on this live and we are like, we're just allowing these things to steal from our life. Like, it's okay to decide to cut things off. It's okay. I'm not telling you to live an isolated, lonely life. But if you're not happy, I don't like to use the word happy. If you're not at peace with the results that you're getting, with the things you're allowing to produce in your life, you have producers in your life, right? Everybody you're around is a producer. What's a producer? They produce something in your life. Everybody you're around produces something in your life. Some of you might have kids say they produce some stress, right? Our kids are our kids. But they produce a lot of love. I'm sure they do. But some of you are willingly keeping producers of negativity in your life. And you expect to have a positive life. It doesn't work like that. Or it's very hard. Some of you have producers of joy in your life. And your life feels great. Because you're surrounding your life around those producers. I want you to spend time tonight. Spend time tonight and ask yourself, what are people in my life producing? What's this environment producing? Who am I following on social media? What are they producing? Some of us, we following people that producing nothing but more comparison, more insecurity in our life, more bitterness, more unhappiness in our life, more stress in our life by the people that we follow, by the people that we're around, by the environments that we're in. Some of us, we keep going to those same environments. I know that was me. I kept going to a certain environment. When I went to that environment, it made me feel a certain type of way. It produced more anxiety, it produced more stress. When I stopped going to that environment, guess what? It stopped producing those things in my life. So you gotta make a decision. And so tonight, some actual, factual, tactical work that you have to, it's not even hard, but the decisions are hard, is to think about, okay, what are things producing in my life? And you gotta ask yourself first and foremost, what do you want the harvest to be in your life? Right? If you want a harvest of peace like I want, you want a harvest of the inner peace, the peace that doesn't work off of what's happening outside of me, the peace that's solidified because I know who I am in God's eyes, the peace that's solidified because I've accepted myself, the peace that solidifies because I stopped judging my worth by outside things, the peace that's solidified in my soul. I know it doesn't work off of these external things. So you got to realize what's the harvest and understand the harvest that you want in your life. Because some of us, we want to harvest, but we're not willing to cut off or promote certain producers in our life. Producers in our life, and we're allowing these things to continue to come into our life and steal. At some point, just think about this, right? I was with my two-year-old today, and I love babies. I love babies. I love even 5, 6-year-olds, right? At some point around 10, 11, the older they get, the more thieves come into their life, right? The more thieves, and I mean by thieves, are the more producers producing seeds of doubt, producing seeds of negativity. The more of that comes into their life. And I'm just looking at my two-year-old, and she's just so full of no expectation, just so full of joy. My five-year-old's the same way, so full of joy and just doing things that they want to do. They're living life the way life is supposed to live. I believe that's why God told us to stay childlike and be childlike. But at some point in life, this has happened to me, we allow things to steal from our life. We allow things to steal our dreams. We allow things to steal our confidence in ourselves. We allow things and people, whatever it may be for you, to just steal. And then at that point, we start becoming what the world wants us to be instead of what we created to be. Get around a child, man. Just get around a child. Some of y'all got children. Get around a child and just study a child. Just study a child and watch how a child acts. Now, there's some things about a child that, you know, obviously you don't want to mimic, but watch how a child acts. Just watch. And then we don't change until the world gets a hold of us. We don't change until the world tells us that's stupid. We don't change until the world tells us that we're ugly. We don't change until the world tells us that we're not enough, right? We're living our best life, and then once the world tells us, or whoever tells us that, nah, you're not supposed to look like this, talk like this, you're not supposed to believe in this, you're not supposed to do none of that, and we sit there and we believe it. We've allowed this world as the greatest thief in our life. Social media is a thief in our life. It's also a great producer too. Right now, social media is producing this to you guys, right? I'm not saying social media is all bad, but for a lot of people, social media is a thief. It's a thief because of what you follow and who you follow and what you choose to be entertained by. The news is a thief. Oftentimes, right? Your environment might be a thief. So it has to come to a point where you understand this and you do something about it. But I just want y'all to think about tonight. I want to just come on here and be raw and just give you this message. It was a message that was on my heart the other day, and I wanted to go on live at that moment. I said, you know, I'm gonna wait till Sunday at 8. And I just want to say this is totally opposite. This holiday season, man, be a giver, okay? There's a lot of people, even myself, man. This is my first Christmas without my mom. right? It's a lot of people dealing with loss, a lot of people dealing with, you know, a lot of pressures and things like that. And I know the whole thing, you shouldn't be focused on gifts, right? We understand all of that, but let's be real. You got kids, man. Kids want gifts. You know, sometimes you feel like, man, I can't provide. I want to tell you right now, if you're a parent in that situation, you are an amazing parent, right? Because at the end of the day, it's not the gifts that you give to your kids. It's the gifts that you put in their hearts. It's the gifts that you help them live their gifts out. That's the most important things. I know that can be a stressful time for people. So one of the things that I'm doing, and I do this every Sunday, silently, and I hate talking about it because I'm a person, I don't like to talk about what I'm doing for people. But I want to just say this. Every Sunday, I silently bless somebody. It could be a small blessing. It could be a big blessing. Every Sunday, I pick a family. I pick a person randomly, and I bless them. Like I said, we all can be a blessing to somebody. It ain't got to be money all the time. It could be whatever. It could be a prayer. It could be help around the house. It could be food that you cook for them. Like, it could be so many things. The smallest things are the most important things in this world. And this Christmas, you know, I'm blessing, you know, make sure you go to my Instagram because I'm blessing a family in Dallas-Fort Worth personally. With Fort Worth, my city, Fort Worth. I want to hands-on bless them, meaning that I want to go meet them and go take them shopping for their kids and all of that stuff. And then also my whole family, we're blessing a family virtually. So meaning that obviously we can't be there, but we're going to bless the family virtually. And then we're also going to bless the family directly on top of what we're doing rehab time. Personally, I'm going to bless the family directly that's been affected by these tornadoes. That's the way I keep my mother's spirit alive. You know, a lot of people ask me like, man, how have you dealt with it? I get messages all the time now because people are looting, man. I know this live is about to take a totally twist, but I've seen so many people hit me up, man, this year about, you know, they've lost. You know, I opened my message the other day, somebody lost their mother in a car accident, and it really touched my soul. And so people have always asked, like, Trent, how have you got through it? How are you dealing with it? And it's the thing that I always tell y'all, man, like, find a way to keep them alive through you. And this is my way of keeping them alive. If you want to feel value in your heart, give to other people. If you want to feel like you're a person of value, give to other people. When I'm depressed, this whole year of me battling depression and me going through my seasons this year that I talked about throughout this whole year, it was me giving to other people that let me know that I have value. Whether it be going live and giving to y'all, this is a way of giving. Or whether it be me financially giving this to somebody, or me coaching a kid, you know, or me, you know, our friends, not even necessarily just me, or people around me, you know, helping just however, in whatever way, small, big. I just want to help, you know, and I can't help everybody, but I can help. And so I want to say that to inspire you to help somebody. You know, even if your situation might not be ideal and you need help, go help somebody. Even in your hardest moments, still go help somebody. Because we need that in this world. And so I was just thinking about today, you know, my kids don't have to worry about certain things, but I know there are a lot of kids out there that do. You know, my kids are healthy right now. I know a lot of kids that aren't healthy. And it's just, if you sit back, man, and I'm very careful with using the word blessed, because I don't want y'all to think you're blessed because you have things. But to me, blessings are the things that money can buy. That's the true blessings. And I sit back and I'm just grateful. I'm grateful for you guys. I'm grateful for having a platform. I'm grateful that I can be able to help and inspire people. I'm grateful that my kids understand giving. You know, I just talked to Maya. We just sat down literally, like right before I got on this live, and I talked to my five-year-old. So I wanted to see if she understood it. And she did. She was like, yeah, Dad, like, I got old stuff I can give away, or even some new stuff. Like, I don't need, you know, and it's so beautiful, man. I just want to just come on here and just really plant that seed of giving in this season, because there's a lot of people in this world that need it, that don't have it. So I appreciate y'all so much, man. And just to kind of recap this message. Just to recap this message. The first part. Just think about that tonight. Just think about what you're allowing. And this is a message I was thinking about with myself. So I'll be coming here so passionate, y'all, because these are conversations that I have with myself a lot. And I'm like, man, I just can't wait to just, because it was an eye opener for me. I was like, man, what thieves do I have in my life? Sometimes the thief is you, right? Sometimes you in your own way. Let's be real. It ain't always somebody else. Sometimes it's you. It's been me a lot of times in my life. And I always say it's me because even if it's not me, I'm allowing it to affect me. So just think about that. And just think about how hard you go for certain things. I always think about that. When I feel like I'm not valuing myself, I always think about what am I valuing more than myself? Like, I will protect, you know, a freaking dumbbell. You know what I'm saying? More than I will protect my heart. Why? Right? Somebody was come taking my dumbbell, I would be like, hey, like, give me my dumbbell back. But then when somebody comes to take my piece, it's just like, we let it slide. You know, we let it slide. And then not even just letting it slide, we allow them to stay. We allow it to stay and continue to take until you have no more left to take. And then those things leave your life. Right? Some of you are at a job, and I'm not telling you to quit your job. But you allow your job to just take until you get to a point where you can't even work anymore, or you can't even work efficiently because you're not filled with anything. You're not appreciated. They have taken the appreciation that you have for yourself and they've given you no appreciation to pour into yourself. And then once you've used up and you're empty, they fire you. Right? I've been in situations like that. I mean, it might not seem like a typical 9-to-5, but the NFL, as crazy as that sounds, I was there. I was allowing that lead to take from me. So, yeah, I hope tonight inspired you a bit. For Instagram, I usually talk about some personal stuff. So, if you haven't been on my Instagram lives, I would suggest you go on Instagram. I'm about to go on there right now. Again, if you're not a part of my text community, join it. And I will say this, if you're just joining it to get a response from me, don't join it because I can't respond to 100,000 people. I spend 60 to 90 minutes a day giving my all and responding back. And I'm going to just be real with y'all. Can I have a real moment? This is usually an Instagram moment, but I'll have it on Facebook right now. Sometimes, man, it does bother me a little bit when people hit me up and I haven't responded to them because I haven't seen it. I mean, I just wish sometimes people can realize, like, even now there's like, 1,400 people. I can't see everybody's comment, but I have 12 million people on Facebook. I can't see every message. And, you know, I'm a person and an influencer, like, that really is connected. Like, that really is, like, me responding to y'all, me hitting y'all up. And sometimes, and this is not everybody, y'all. This is probably, like, 1%, but I do want to say it. It does bother me sometimes when people be like, oh, you don't care. I'm just like, what? How would y'all ever get, I don't care? You know what I mean? When you got freaking robots that be talking to y'all. You know, a lot of these influencers or celebrities, it don't even be them at all on their stuff. And so I say that to say, if you hit me up on my text message just to get a response from me, that's not the place. You might get one, but statistically, mathematically, it's probably not going to happen. You probably have a better chance of winning the lotto because there's just so many people on there. Some of you have gotten responses from me. Some of you have gotten blessed from me. But it's just, you know, it's kind of like the percentages of actually that happening is very small. So if you're there, but if you want inspiration, if you want to get information on like things like this when we're donating back, helping people, or, you know, when I'm releasing things or doing things or murder, whatever it may be, that's the place. Okay, but especially for daily inspiration, because we send out text messages every day that hopefully inspire you. I love y'all. I appreciate y'all. Thank you. But peace out. Let's get it.
Hey, what's up, rehabs across the world? Trent here. Thank you for watching our new video. I hope it impacted your life. Listen, we're impacting lives all across the world. I want you to know this. It's because of you. It's because of you supporting the messages and sharing the messages. And speaking about sharing the messages, if this video touched your heart, if it's on your heart, please press share, because I promise you this, there's somebody in the world right now that needs to watch this video. And by you pressing share, you become a hero in their life. I get messages every single day say, Trent, I had no idea what Rehab Time was yesterday, but my friend shared the video. I saw it on the timeline, and man, did I need it. We're gonna continue to impact the world only with your help. We appreciate you. But like I say at the end of every single video, it all starts with you. It's Rehab Time.